unbearable. And I know it's... I should never have come here.
We wouldn't, honey, if they hadn't moved our booking. We'll be in the Metropole tomorrow night. The honeymoon suite.
Why did we have to come here?
We didn't want to sleep in the street now, did we?
I know, but this... and the heat.
Lisa's plan. Goodness sake.
Ted, where are you going?
Going to find someone to make this fan work.
Ted, don't leave me alone here.
Oh, you'll be all right, honey. I'll be right back.
Ted! Ted! Ted, this bed's...
Mocha? No, Ta.
Ted?
See you soon.
Ted? Ted?
My wife.
Every government has its Secret Service branch. America, it's CIA. France, Deuxième Bureau. England, MI5. A messy job? Well, that's when they usually call on me or someone like me. Oh, yes. My name is Drake. John Drake. It was a June wedding for Joan Baker, née Anderson. She left her mother in Cheltenham, England, to fly to the mysterious East, where her husband, Captain Baker, was stationed. They stopped to honeymoon on the island of Bantong. The day they arrived, he was charged with murder. Now, a month later, he sat waiting in the death cell. And his wife, she just lay in bed and wished that she could die too.
Who is it?
My name is Drake, John Drake.
Look, Mr. Drake, I'm afraid I can't see anyone right now. I'm ill, I just can't.
Sorry, Mrs. Baker, you see, I've come all the way from Washington. I'm here to try and help you.
Would you please come back later?
No, Mrs. Baker. We haven't very much time, you see. I have a few questions to ask you, and then I promise I'll go.
There's nothing you can do. There's nothing anyone can do.
Perhaps you'd let me be the best judge of that. Now, would you like to tell me just what happened?
But I don't see how it does.
Starting right at the beginning, you booked in at the Kai Lung Hotel.
That dreadful place.
Well, a little primitive, perhaps, but a very ordinary hotel. You booked in, went upstairs, and then what happened?
There, Mr. Drake. There's the typescript of the trial. It'll tell you everything.
Thank you very much, but I'd rather that you told me everything, Mrs. Baker.
No, I can't. I'm ill. I wish I could die. I do. I just wish it...
You have my deepest sympathy, but I don't think you're in any danger of dying. Your husband is. He needs all the help we can give him.
There's nothing anyone can do. Mr. Drake, I'm ill. Will you please go? Will you please go away?
Very well. I have to see the Minister of Justice. Perhaps I can come back later on. By the time I contacted the Minister of Justice, he was leaving his office. He invited me to meet him at his home. I introduced myself as a special correspondent, a representative of the international press.
What my readers would be interested to know, Mr. Minister, is exactly what form of justice you intend to mete out to Captain Baker.
Please.
Thank you.
Unfortunately, Mr. Drake, we have no choice. Under our new democratic laws, there is no other penalty for Captain Baker but death.
Thank you. But surely this wasn't murder, let us say, manslaughter.
Our people are simple, Mr. Drake. That distinction would be too subtle for them.
Yes, but Baker had never even seen the man before he, unfortunately, shot him.
Yes. That is one of the things that went against him at the trial. The man he killed had a wife and four small children. That a stranger should come here, a man he had never met, and shoot him for no apparent reason, why, that's primitive, barbaric.
Yes, I read all about it in your popular press. Still doesn't make it murder, Mr. Minister. Have you any idea why Baker put up no defense?
That's his business. If you would care to read the transcript of the trial, you will find it is all legally correct.
Oh, yes, I read it. Thank you very much indeed. It makes Bantong just about as popular as arsenic to the people of the West.
There is an unfortunate tendency among Westerners to think that they are exempted from foreign laws when they are abroad. Now, this must be corrected if the Bantonese people are to feel any pride in their new democracy. Good day, Mr. Drake.
Good day, Mr. Minister. Thank you very much.
The jail had the appearance and amenities of a medieval dungeon.
John Drake, International Press.
I must see your pass.
My pass? That's right. Here we are. Thank you.
Their security was meticulous. They were taking no chances. The minister hadn't the slightest intention of letting his victim escape the execution chamber. I'd met Captain Baker the year before on a job that brought me into contact with the Signals Corps. Would he remember me?
Gentlemen.
Hiya, Ted.
Talk. How are things, Ted?
Hey, what's up? No, thank you. I'm trying to cut down on my smoking.
How are they treating you?
Well, I haven't anything to complain about. Even the food's pretty good, if you like rice.
Do you think the trial was a fair one?
Yes, it was fair enough. But the sentence, it was tough, tougher than I expected. I've registered an appeal on that count, and I still have hopes of a pardon.
No luck, Ted.
The Minister of Justice has turned me down, huh? Well, I didn't expect anything else. The elections are due in a couple of months. He's going to run in opposition to the president.
Yeah, standing up to the Westerners, a pretty good vote catcher down here.
Sure, they're shouting for my blood, and the Minister of Justice is in a position to see they get it. Let's hope the electorate show their gratitude.
They're still the president.
Not a chance. He's not committing political suicide to save Ted Baker's neck.
Why'd you plead guilty, Ted?
I shot him. I had no case. Why, Mr. Drake, what are you? Are you a press man now?
I'm still working for the same old firm.
Well, say, would you call up my wife and see if you can help her? She's at the Metropole.
I'm doing what I can.
Well, thanks, but this is one that even you can't beat.
Well, can we get a picture?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Who is it?
Great.
Just a minute.
Oh, may I? Oh, I'm glad to see you're feeling better.
There's no use staying in bed and putting one's head under the clothes.
That's right. Are you more in a mood for talking now?
I gave you the transcript of the trial.
That's right, and I read it. It made me wonder. Would it be too much to ask you just to tell me the story in your own words?
But why? My evidence was all there.
Yes, indeed, and if I may say so, I think you told it very clearly, but there are still a couple of points. Could you give me a rundown from the time your husband left the bedroom?
Must I?
Yes, you must.
Very well. The fan wouldn't work, so Ted went out to try and find someone to fix it.
Leaving the door open?
Yes, that's how the man got in. I thought it was Ted come back, and then I looked up and saw this man leaning over me. I screamed for Ted, but he still wouldn't get out.
He must have been very persistent.
Yes, he was. Anyway, then Ted came back and grabbed up his gun and told the man to get out. Then he turned and tried to take Ted's gun away. I mean, there was nothing else poor Ted could do.
Bang.
It wasn't funny, Mr. Drake. We were on our honeymoon.
Oh, yes, I know. It's a difficult time. It's just one thing that I don't understand, though. Why didn't the intruder leave when he was told? You see, he was trying to find room 24, and since the numbers on his key tag were printed one above the other, it was a natural mistake for a Bantanese to try and get into room 42. You see, they read from the bottom up.
And I suppose he'd never stayed in a hotel before.
It's possible. I mean, he was a farmer of peasant stock.
And he was perfectly innocent, is that it?
No, the point I'm trying to make is that he had nothing in mind when he came into the room. You're a very attractive woman, Mrs. Baker, but I doubt if even your charms could hold a man who has been screamed at and threatened with a gun.
He was drunk, and he was big, and he was vicious.
And he was trapped.
Exactly, he
was trying to get out of the room, but couldn't work the lock. That's it, isn't it?
We were in a strange country. We were on edge. I know it seems terrible to think of it now, but we thought he was trying to bolt the door, not get out of the room. And then he came towards us.
Us?
Yes, Ted and me.
If the door locked itself when the man entered, how did Ted get back in?
Why, with his key, of course.
If he had his key, why did he leave the door ajar when he went to get the porter? You shot him, didn't you? In a blind panic, you shot him when he was trying to leave the room. And now your husband is taking the blame for you. He must love you very much indeed, Mrs. Baker.
Get out of here. Just keep out of this.
I think you ought to allow me to try and help you, Mrs. Baker.
I don't want your help. I don't need it. Everything's going to be all right. Guard?
What are you up to? Have the authorities been trying to make a deal with you by any chance?
Just tell this gentleman to get out.
All right, I'm going. Goodbye, Mrs. Baker. Very nice meeting you. Very interesting chap.
Only the president knew my true identity. The Baker affair had placed him in a political dilemma. He was a worried man. But what happened to Ted Baker seemed to be the least of his worries.
Mr. Drake, the one thing which I cannot do is to give this Captain Baker a pardon. I would be committing political suicide.
And what if I were to arrange a jailbreak, Mr. President?
Saving Baker's life is not really the problem.
It is to Baker.
You see, if I were to reprieve and deport him, my stock with the Western powers would soar. But, Mr. Drake, that man who pulled you here in the rickshaw, he has a vote now. And he and a million other coolies think Baker should die. If I reprieve him, then where do I stand in the coming elections?
Oh, but you can't ignore Western opinion, sir. If I may suggest, your country still survives on loans from the West, does it not?
That is my dilemma, Mr. Drake. I am over a barrel, as they say in Bantong.
And winning an election is more important than a man's life.
Mr. Drake, one more term in office, and I shall have established my people in a position of freedom and prosperity which they have not enjoyed for 1,000 years. Is that not more important than Baker's life?
Yes, but you called me here to see if I could find a way to save him.
No, no. I call you here to find a way to save us both.
Supposing Mrs. Baker were to make a full confession that it was she who did the killing.
Her story would have to be convincing.
It happens to be true.
It is not the truth that matters. It is what will be believed. If we could pull it off, Captain Baker would be the hero of the hour. What marital devotion. And the popular Mr. Chung, our Minister of Justice, would come under severe censure for having attempted to bring about a miscarriage of justice. I should like this, Mr. Drake. Yes.
And Mrs. Baker?
I could safely deport her. We rarely jail women. We have found over the centuries that a length of bamboo applied by the husband brings more lasting satisfaction to all concerned.
Very democratic. I'll see what I can do. Thank you very much, Mr. President. Au revoir.
you I did it. You said if I kept quiet, Ted would be safe.
Mrs. Baker, do you question my word?
Ted only has until the day after tomorrow. You said we'd be out of here by now. You've just made one promise after another. No, wait. I'm sorry. Please forgive me.
No, Mrs. Baker, I'm doing everything I can to help. Now, if that is not enough...
Oh, no, no, please wait. I do trust you. I must now. Just tell me what to do.
Nothing, Mrs. Baker. Leave it to me. On Thursday at 9 o'clock, Captain Baker will be taken to a place called the Garden of Farewells. That is where the unfortunate say goodbye to their loved ones. He will then, in his own time, go through the door at the end of the garden called the Door to Paradise.
Is that where
it? Yes. The execution yard. Now, I will tell the American newsmen that to see him in the garden would be too much of a strain for you. You will at that time be boarding a plane to the United States.
No, not without Ted, I won't.
Captain Baker will be taken out through the door and be shown straight through into the street and into a car.
Oh, I see. You're not lying to me.
Mrs. Baker, you must trust me. Trust in me, all will be well.
Oh, Mr. Chung.
Before you call that guard again, Mrs. Baker, perhaps you'd give me a minute.
What do you want?
Come to sell you some insurance.
I don't need your help.
You know, Mrs. Baker, I'm beginning to wonder if you care enough even to want to save Ted. As long as you get clear of this, I don't think you really mind, do you? So, I was wrong. Would you like to read the policy?
But this is a confession saying I killed that man.
That's right. Sign it and Ted can go free.
Mr. Drake, he knows what I'm doing. I'm 24 and I'm not going to spend the rest of my life in jail if we can both get free.
You won't have to go to jail, I give you my word.
Everybody's given me their word. It doesn't mean a thing. I just want to go home.
All right, supposing that I am lying, isn't it better to go to jail than to see your husband executed?
Ted won't be executed. Mr. Chung has assured me.
You believe him, do you?
I don't know what
you believe. That fairy tale about escaping from the execution yard?
Yes.
It's going to be in all the papers, Mrs. Baker. Perhaps you haven't heard, but there are a lot of people in this country that want to see that execution take place. If Mr. Chung allows him to escape, he's going to lose a lot of votes in the ballot box.
He gave his word.
And you're willing to stake your husband's life on it? Thank you. And the other one. Thank you very much. Now, the worst that can happen to you is deportation.
Please, Mr. Drake, don't say anything more. I'm sorry I signed it already. Will you please go?
Very well. Goodbye. You'll be hearing from me very soon.
Frightened, Mrs. Baker. We'll see that this man doesn't bother you again. Come with me,
He's
sir.
He's perfectly all right, officer. Mr. Drake is a friend.
I quite understand. He broke into your room. He molested you. Please.
But you're making a mistake. I told you.
Well, you're wasting your time, Mrs. Baker. I'm afraid the lieutenant hasn't the slightest intention of understanding. After you.
No, sir. After you.
Oh, thank you very much. I never saw the Minister of Justice, but I could feel him pulling the strings in the background.
Well, Mr. Drake, I'm sorry to have detained you. I trust yourself was comfortable.
It was a joy.
Mrs. Baker has decided to prefer no charges, so you're free to go.
I'm much obliged.
Here's your passport, wallet, change, press pass, keys. I think you'll find everything in order.
Oh, yes. Thank you very much. Oh, there were a couple of sheets of typescript in my wallet. Could I have those, please?
Ah, yes. They're here on the receipt.
Are they?
Yes. Two sheets of paper. Well, I must apologize, but our people are so careless. They're always losing things. Perhaps if you come back tomorrow,
I'd be wasting my time, don't you?
Oh, no, Mr. Drake. We would not think of confiscating private property. We are a democracy now.
Oh, yes, of course. I was forgetting. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Is Mrs. Baker out?
Mrs. Baker, sir? She gone, sir. Gone home on boat. Catch new man. You Mr. Drake?
That's right.
Here. She asked me to give this to you.
Right. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
I'm hoping that somehow you will get this letter. They are putting me on a ship this afternoon. I tried to contact our embassy, but they wouldn't let me make any calls. I know now that Chung was lying to me all the time. He is not going to let Ted escape. Please, Mr. Drake, do what you can. You're our only hope.
Mr. Drake, I'm as sorry as you are, but Chung Sun has outmaneuvered us. He has taken care that no one shall see Mrs. Baker until after the execution. And her willingness to confess is not, I'm afraid, a confession.
There's one way left, sir.
Oh, what is that?
A rather desperate measure. I could attempt a jailbreak.
And what are the chances, Mr. Drake?
Well, I've seen the prison. I think it could be done.
Then say no more. I know nothing about it.
I quite understand. I believe that Captain Baker is having his final press conference
if
this evening.
If Captain Baker could escape execution, what a blunder that would be on the part of the Minister of Justice. Good luck, Mr. Drake. But if things should go wrong, do not expect any help from me.
Thank you very much. Show him your camera. You've forgotten your flash gear.
Huh? Oh, I must have left it in the car.
Yeah. Hurry up. Back. Have you got a light match?
It's not there.
Oh, for Pete's sake, have another look. Try the trunk, will you?
Yeah.
Leave the camera with me in case you forget that, too. What a nut.
So far?
No, gentlemen. It looks as though my luck's run out.
Do you feel any resentment, Ted?
I certainly do. A few years back, I fought to give this country its freedom. That is, along with a few hundred thousand other guys. If I'd known then that they were going to thank me so handsomely, I wouldn't have troubled.
Will you be seeing Mrs. Baker again today?
Could you oblige me? Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'll be seeing you.
Within 3.5 minutes, we were enjoying the delectable scents of Bantong Harbor. And that night, we sailed away from trouble on a trading junk bound for Hong Kong. We'll be right back.
Thank you.